Welcome back, and in this lesson I want to take a sample question which you might find in the exam and break it down, helping you to understand the process which I go through when answering questions. Now this specific question is taken from the tutorialsdojo.com practice exam for the Advanced Networking Specialty Certification, and it's taken with their permission, so let's quickly step through it and explain the steps which I go through in an exam when answering this type of question. Now let's read through the question in the same way that you would have to do in the exam. So the question is, an online delivery system is hosted in an auto-scaling group of EC2 instances deployed across multiple availability zones with an application load balancer in front to distribute the incoming traffic. A network engineer has been instructed to decouple the system and route different types of requests to specific target groups. Each workload type will have a dedicated group of EC2 instances. If there is an incoming request with a URL of server/API/electronics, it must be forwarded to a specific target group named electronics-target-group. And if a request has a URL of server/API/books, then it should be forwarded to another separate target group named books-target-group. How can the engineer implement this change in AWS? Now this is a lot of text to read through and process, so to cut down the cognitive overhead, we have to do keyword identification. So give this a try yourself while pausing the video, and then you can resume it and we can compare. Now I hope you've given this a try. Let's move across and compare what you found to what I found. Now this is an interesting question because there's a lot of information which you need to interpret and then review when answering the question. The way that I suggest dealing with a question at this length is to think about it in phases. Read the text, identify the big and obvious items, and then review the answers to see if you have enough information to eliminate or select enough answers to complete the specific question. For example, this is what I found. I identified auto-scaling group and EC2 instances, and this could indicate a certain type of scaling within this architecture. I also identified multiple availability zones, and this might be important when answering the question. Now, application load balancer, this is specifically mentioned, and often this matters. If the question just said load balancer, then I tend to think that it's not important to the question. But in this particular case, it specifically says application load balancer, so maybe this is important. Now, a really important thing which I did spot in the question text is a specific mention of URL. URLs belong to the application layer, and the fact that application load balancer is also mentioned, this strikes me as important. Then you have specific target group, which seems to suggest directing a specific URL at a specific target group using an application load balancer. Now this last part strikes me as important, so keep this in mind as we review the answers together. Now these are the answers that we have available as part of this question. First, add a listener in the application load balancer with two path conditions for the electronics and books target groups. The second is replace your application load balancer with a network load balancer, create a new listener with path conditions for the electronics and books target groups. The third is set up a new listener in the application load balancer with host conditions for the electronics and books target groups. And the final answer is create a new listener in the application load balancer with two host header conditions for the electronics and books target groups. So we have four answers, and given that the question doesn't specify how many answers we need to select, then we need to default to picking one answer. So go ahead and pause the video, and I want you to review the answer text and attempt to identify any keywords which you think are important. So go ahead and do that and then resume the video, and we can compare what you found to what I found. Okay, so this is what I found as important in the answers. The first answer mentions two path conditions, and that's important because in other answers we also have different conditions being mentioned. The second answer suggests replacing your application load balancer with a network load balancer, and that's a relatively major change in architecture. The third answer mentions host conditions, and the fourth answer mentions host header conditions. So we have two different approaches, two different sets of answers. One which recommends changing an application load balancer to a network load balancer, and then three others which talk about different types of conditions. Now, the reason why I'm highlighting it in this way is the answer to this question is really simple to select, and it's based on one single keyword. Notice how in the question it mentioned URL. Remember, URL is a layer 7 thing, and layer 7 is the application layer. So that's critical to understand in order to answer this question. The reason why it's critical is this allows us to eliminate answer B, because answer B talks about replacing an application load balancer with a network load balancer, and a network load balancer is unable to understand layer 7, and so it can't use any layer 7 items, in this case a URL and a path, so we can eliminate answer B. So now we have three answers which state different condition types. We have path, host conditions, and host header conditions. Now the question has one really important keyword, and that's URL. The question wants us to direct a certain URL, so server API electronics, to one target group, and another URL, so server API books, to a different target group. And this is using a path condition. So because of this, we can eliminate answer C, because this is a host condition, and this won't allow us to redirect based on the full URL that's used. Likewise, we can eliminate answer D, because again, we need to direct based on the contents of a URL. And this leaves us one answer, which is answer A, the correct answer, because the question talks about URLs, which are layer 7, and because the question mentions URL plus path, we need to pick path conditions in order to direct all of the incoming traffic towards a specific target group. And if you look at how I've approached this question, even though the question and answers are relatively wordy, I've only focused on the really important keywords which are used. In this particular case, all that we had to do was focus on the fact that the question wanted us to direct specific URLs to specific target groups. And because of that, we could eliminate network load balancers and all of the different condition types apart from path conditions. And that leaves us with one possible answer, which is answer A. Now, once again, this question was taken from tutorialsdojo.com, and I do highly recommend that you check out this site if you do need any extra exam practice once you've attempted the practice exam included with this course. And I've included a link attached to this lesson for the appropriate practice exam on Tutorials Dojo. With that being said, go ahead and complete this video, and once you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.